Scorpios, it's Tori, the home dealer of guided intuition, and I'm here to do your monthly spiritual guidance from Spirit, your guides, Jesus, Allah, the universe, whatever it is you believe in, Scorpio. This is what they want you to pay attention to in the month of February. So, my loves, I want you to keep in mind that this may resonate, it may not. However, there are so many beautiful souls that are sharing their gifts. You're going to find someone who picks up on your energy. So if the shoe does not fit, don't force it. Also, any information on how to contact me or about my channel, you can find in the description box below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, okay? Friendly. So, Scorpio. I know last month that I did not do a monthly spiritual guidance. So what I want to do is I want to take you through a trip through memory lane. I'm going to go ahead and pull three cards to really see, you know, what major lessons or what did you experience in the month of January that you're going to be carrying over to you in February, okay? Now, as I was getting ready to do your reading, as I was shuffling the cards, saging the cards, and all of that good stuff, there were a couple of things that I found myself doing that I feel like is going to be vital for you in the month of February. First and foremost, before you make a sound decision in any area of your life, Scorpio, it's very important that you get all of the details. It's very important that you seek guidance, that you seek wisdom, you know, read up on it. Make sure that you have all of the pieces, all of the information before you move forward, okay? When I say get all of the information, I'm asking you in the month of February to look at life, your relationships, yourself, your career, whatever it is, Scorpio, look at it through a larger lens, not so narrowed. Don't get lost in the details, okay? Because details can change. Details can, you know, nothing is permanent. So I'm asking you to be open-minded, okay? Also, you know, maybe there's a situation where the fine details is aggravating the out of you, okay? It could be a situation in love. It could be in career. It could be in your family. It's just like the small details, like you're just zoning in on, you know, you're just, and instead of like looking at the whole, okay, I'll do this. I'll do this example because this was hitting me out. With this setup, okay, it's very nice. It's very relaxing. It's very chill. However, the candles are irritating the hell out of me right now in this very moment. And instead of, you know, just looking at everything else, zooming in on the candles, okay, that's my thing. I'm like zooming in on the candles. And I feel like there, you know, there's going to come a time in your life that there might be a situation that right now that's not, it's not ideal. It's not horrible, but it's not grand. You get what I'm saying? Maybe you can't, I feel like for some, you can't change it yet, but Spirit is saying, listen, look through think bigger, think larger, okay? And then for some, I feel like maybe there is just something that you keep looking at that you genuinely don't like. Change it, okay? You're not just limited. There we go. That's the energy that I'm picking up. You're not just limited to this one thing. Maybe it's just because this is what you're choosing to look at. Say if it's a family member, just say if it's something, you know, that is out of your control. You, Scorpio, can choose what it is you choose to look at and what it is you choose to zone in on. That's what I feel like Spirit is asking you to look at something through a bigger lens, okay? Because when you do that, so many doors, so many opportunities are going to open up for you. I really feel like there's a lot changing, a lot shifting in the month of February, but it's due to whatever transpired, whatever transformation happened to you, Scorpio, in the month of January. So let's just see what major lessons did Scorpio learn in the month of January that they're bringing over into February, Spirit. Let's see. We have the desert, okay? So I feel like, Scorpio, there could have possibly been a drought of some sort, be it in a relationship, meeting your finances, because the root chakra is really coming up, and that houses our money, our finances, our foundation, you know. And with the desert here, what is a desert? A desert is dry. I really feel like there was some, out of some difficult situation, was a perfect opportunity to build a new foundation, have a new outlook on life or a new perspective, you know, right here. Okay. We also have, I'm not going to mess this word up, but we're going to really see. I see like the web, okay? The web. And then we have the lovers, okay? So this is what I'm seeing right here. For some of my Scorpios, you're being asked. I feel like in the month of January, you had to take a look at a particular relationship. It could have been love related. That's the one that I'm really feeling, but I'm also feeling family. Maybe, you know, it was a situation or a partnership, a business ship, some kind of ship that really was not feeding, really isn't feeding what it is that you need as far as a stable foundation, okay? Whatever that looks like. And, you know, with this web right here, with this web, I feel like maybe you and this person have a deeper connection. You have roots. You're entangled. This is why I feel like it could be family. It also could be like a long-term relationship. Maybe it's a cycle that you guys have been in, Scorpio. And I feel like there's something that you need to, you know, maybe speak up or step up to the plate with this desert here. Where your needs are not getting met or getting fed is what I'm seeing. I feel like someone has a decision to make. Either you're going to keep feeding a situation that's not really feeding you, not really giving you nothing back, okay? Or are you going to untangle yourself, all right, and move towards a connection or be open to a connection that is truly more of divine energy? That's what I feel. That's what I'm hearing right now. I just feel like for somebody, there's been a situation. It could be a relationship. It could be a family member. It could be career wise. For each of you, it could be different. But I feel like there's a situation that maybe you've been giving, you know. And I just feel like it's time to like let it go. But you're intertwined in it, so you have to make a decision. And I feel like this is why Spirit, you know, in the month of February, is asking you to come up, you know. Know that, you know, don't limit yourself, Scorpio. I feel like there is a limitless opportunities that lead to success, but it's something that you are zoning in this current moment. And I just feel like you're trying to make it work, but the desert here, for whatever reason, it's just not giving back to you. And Spirit is asking you to open your heart, open your soul, like, you know, broaden your horizon is what I'm hearing right here. Because if you come out of whatever this desert moment is, you know, if you come out of it, there's so much, you'll see that there's so much beauty. And I feel like maybe in, you know, and not in October, I keep saying October, but maybe in January, you know, you had an epiphany. You know, you can't keep feeding a situation and it's getting you nowhere. You know, maybe you stepped off and channeled your energy and your focus into something that really, that means more to you. Because in the month of February, we got infinity here. That card fell out and I was guided to, you know, read this message. We know what infinity is: an endless and boundless, unlimited space, time and quantity, okay, without limit or end. Often this card is drawn when you are at a crossroad in your life. You may be asked to make an important decision. Be very clear and know that there are vast possibilities available. You do have choices. Choose wisely and honestly from what you truly feel inside and from where you are now in your life. Okay? Don't be bound by old, outdated belief systems. You hear me? So I really feel, Scorpio, There is unlimited opportunities in love, unlimited opportunities in career, unlimited opportunities all around you. But what's going to have to happen in the month of February, you're going to have to come out of your mind. You're going to have to make some decisions. You're going to have to walk away from, for some of you, you're going to have to walk away from a situation that I feel like you have just been, it's been a never-ending web and you've always got the short end of the stick. Be it in career-wise, maybe a way that you're looking at career, you know, the belief of, you know, this is, you know, you can only do this. You can only have this. I'm in a relationship. This is the only thing that you have. This is the only person you can get. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like there's something with outdated beliefs that spirit is bringing you up on. And it says, choose wisely and honestly. Don't be bound by old, outdated belief systems. Take down the boundaries. You are limitless. Tap into the endless bounties of the universe. The energy is flowing really high. Boundless energy is assorted with choosing this card. An excellent time for making positive changes. It says, outside energy. Energies are very impactful at this time. There may be more going on than meets the eye. So this is why I said, you know, gather all your wisdom. All your wisdom and ask yourself, Scorpio, is this what's best for you at this time? Someone's making a decision like that in the month of February. And I feel like it's, or even if you did it in January, it's really going to open your horizons in the month of February, okay? So I want to look at something because these are some extra cards that came out and Spirit wanted me to open up with this. It's very important, Scorpio, when it comes to making these decisions, that you really step in your Leo power, that you really be confident and not only say, you know, not only make a decision, but follow through with it. I will. I will. So that to me is action. Take an action on the decisions that you make. Okay. We also have Aries here. I am, knowing your worth, knowing what you deserve, you know what I'm saying? Knowing what it is that you want out of life, because that's how you call it to you. Maybe you just been letting it, you know, go right here, the air element, communicating, okay? It's time to communicate. Scorpio, oh my God, listen, we have all of it. Fire, no, we don't have earth, but fire, water, air. Listen, for somebody, it's time to clear the air. And I feel like the more that you make these tough decisions, you know, the more that you're going to come out on top and be successful. We have I will with Leo, Aries, I am. So fire is very potent. It's time for you to communicate. We have communicating. So I feel like it's time for you to really step into your personal power. You know, Scorpio, you can make whatever it is that you want happen. Nothing is holding you. So something major that's happening for you in the month of February. We have 11th house, friends, third house, messages. All right, Uranus, genius, okay? And then we have Aquarius, I know. So you have I will, I am, I know. I will, I am, I know. And y'all all, you know, I always talk about the keys to making your wildest dreams a reality. Self-love, self-worth, and self-acceptance. I am self-worth. No, self-love. I am, okay, is self-love. I'm going to love myself. I'm going to choose better for myself. I am is self-love. I know self-worth. I know what I deserve. And I won't stop until that is what it is. Acceptance, I will. That can go for the same thing. I will honor me. I will do what's best for me. I will accept what I need to accept so I can be the best me. These affirmations right here, I am, I know, I will. These are powerful words. And when you put these words with a made up mind, Scorpio, when you have that fierce Aries energy supporting you, when you have that Leo, the confidence to embrace your naked weirdo truth with this Aquarius here, endless opportunities. Any of these statements, you just don't settle. You just don't take the first thing thrown at you. You know what I'm saying? Like, these are power moves right here. And I feel like that's what you're coming into. I know. It's a very transformational month for you, Scorpio. And it's highlighting your relationships right here, the 11th house, friends. Okay, so listen to what the 11th house rules, okay? But there's this quote that I want to read to you. It says, "Don't walk behind me, I may not lead. Don't walk in front of me, I may not follow. Just walk beside me and be my friend, Anonymous." And I feel like these, you're like, if your relationships, your friendships are being highlighted. Because Scorpio, you're seeing what deserves to be in your life and what doesn't deserve to be in your life, okay? Just how I just changed that whole scenery. Those two candles, you know, blew out, okay? They blew out. I took them away and I made, quote unquote, something out of nothing. And I feel like that's what's happening for your friendships and your relationships. Okay, you're moving things around. You're shifting. You're changing. But it also says, you know, with the 11th house, you know, what it means briefly is friendships, friends of all kinds, allies. Okay, social contracts, organizations, clubs, gatherings, dreams, hopes, aspirations, destiny, compassionate, acceptance. Okay. The place where we discover we are not alone, being different, individuals of all kind. So I feel like there's a great group of people entering your life, friendships that are divinely orchestrated. Scorpio, that at first you're like, no, I feel like you're not going to be so open towards. But just know that these are God sent. Because whatever you're moving out, you're making room for some new ones to come in, okay? And I feel like you're going to be evaluating, like, you know, maybe the effort or the time that you put into friendships and seeing, well, you know what? I really want to water this. I really want this to grow. I really want to, you know, add something to it is what I'm seeing. Also, we have the third house dealing with messages. And even with the, you know, the Egyptian signs and the eye, and I'm seeing like spirit is really giving you a lot of downloads. Spirit is speaking to you. And I feel like listen to your intuition, but also look around you. There's a deeper sense of wanting to find wisdom, to go deeper, the seeker. That's what I see you really taking on in the month of, you know, February, especially with your spiritual, your spiritual journey, your spiritual relationship, whatever that is. Scorpio, but I feel like on a spiritual level, you're going deeper. You and the divine's relationship, okay? We also have, I'm gonna mess this up, Uranus. genius, but listen, okay? Usually when we have great aha moments or we have a transformation, it comes from some of the most unlikely places, okay? And it says, according to the myth, out of chaos emerges two expressions of deities, Gaia, Mother Earth, and Uranus, Father Sky. So I feel like there's a great balance coming in for you guys when it comes to your masculine and feminine energy. Also, I feel like there's a balance or a union coming in with a love relationship. I see right here a balance. Maybe it was out of balance. Maybe it was one person, you know, just giving and, you know, the other person wasn't. I feel like if it's been like that, because I just, when I seen that, I say twin flames. So if you identify being on that journey, I feel like there's a balance. There's something coming into balance with a connection of some sort. Okay. But it depends on you speaking up, Scorpio, and really, setting the stage and saying what it is that you need to thrive. That's what I see. Okay. Another thing that, you know, Uranus means, let's see. It says rapid change. Yeah. A lot of change. And some of these changes, you know, Scorpio, it's just like, oh my God, where's all this coming from? But I promise you, this change that is coming in your life in the month of February is for the better. Even if it quite doesn't seem like it, even if it's uncomfortable, I need you to trust and know that these changes that are happening are for the better. Okay, so now we're going to see what is crowning you. What are the things that you're thinking about in the month of February that spirit is downloading, you know, into your spirit? Let's just see. We got a lot of cards wanting to come out, okay? And the first one we have is finances. So I feel like there's something's being highlighted with your finances. Either some of you are like getting a new job, you've been waiting, you've been trying to figure out how something's going to happen. You're getting a lot of messages and downloads from spirit, and I feel like the financial clarity that you're searching for, Scorpio, is right in front of you. Okay? That's what I'm seeing. Also, what's crowning some of you guys is get some rest. Take some time out for yourself. It's not all going to fall apart if you step away momentarily, okay? And I feel like also with finances, I said it, new career, new job opportunities, new career opportunities, some business venture that you're going to be applying for or going to be receiving. For some of you, this business venture, you're going to be moving. And I feel like this is state, out of country. You're going to be moving. And also, I'm feeling like just moving into like, could be switching like apartments or houses, but I really feel like you're going to be moving a distance for a career. And if you have been a little nervous about that or not sure, I feel like this is the go. You know, you're stronger than you know you are. I feel like this new career move or whatever it is going to take courage. I feel like Scorpio, with all these changes and these life decisions that you're making, you're being guided, you know, to tap into that inner powers, tap into your strength. Because whatever is happening in the month of February is for your spiritual growth. You're on a spiritual journey, like really, really connecting with the divine, connecting with your truth, connecting what you deem suitable for you as far as on a spiritual level. Okay. And I feel like by the decisions that you're making and really going to seek the wisdom that's being downloaded into your heart, there's going to be a windfall of abundance. Okay. When you open your perspective, when you open the lens that you've been viewing life through, so many doors are going to open for you. It's just going to be a windfall of blessings and opportunities that maybe you didn't see before because you were just zoomed into this one particular thing. Okay. So that's what's crowning my Scorpio loves. We're going to see what else. Now we're going to move into love. What does Spirit want Scorpio to know about love in the month of February? Okay, first, it doesn't matter if you're single in a relationship. This is what the frequency of love needs from you. We have expression, okay? You are ready to manifest your thoughts and transform them into acts of love. So I feel like they're getting the nudge, Scorpio, that you're ready for love. You're ready to open up, okay? With purpose here, I feel like there's a divine connection coming together. And maybe you're a little scared in February, but I really feel like whatever you're scared of, you don't have anything to worry about. Okay, I feel like there's a divine connection coming in. And then for some, I feel like you're going to be freeing yourself, expressing, you know, that how I'm seeing this. Let's just say it. For some of you, I'm seeing this as you're going to be walking away from a relationship for a career opportunity or vice versa. Somebody's walking away from you. Scorpio, due to some kind of money situation, career situation, but I feel like this is what you needed because maybe you couldn't untangle yourself from this connection and this person ultimately made the decision for you. And I know that sucks, but I promise you there's new love. There's a divine connection coming in for you. Yeah, we have release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. For some of you, this is a physical person, but also energetic. And I feel like when you release this person, maybe you thought this person was just the one. It was just everything. I feel like when you release this person, I don't care what kind of connection it is. When you release this person, I feel like, you know, a soulmate is going to come in. Okay. And then for some of you, maybe you have released this person. But they could definitely be coming back around to express their love. Maybe they had to go away to work on themselves. But I feel like whether you want something, the old thing back, or you want a new thing, either way, I really feel like there is an opportunity for love to grow, Scorpio, in the month of, you know, February. I'm also hearing playfulness. Maybe it's gotten too serious and I'm Spirit is just saying, bring the playfulness back into your connection, back into your love life. Okay, but yeah, this is true love. This is romance of a lifetime. Maybe you were considering releasing a person and it's totally up to you, but maybe you had questions. Yes, this is a soulmate. Yes, it is. It is, you know, true love. But I feel like what needs to happen is you need to get on the same page and have a heart-to-heart conversation. Honestly, discuss your feelings with each other. But you have to get clear too, because I feel like for some of you, you're going to be taking a new beginning right here with this bear. This is all about new beginnings, a new dawn, a new day. And this could be in a connection that you're already with this person or someone new. But I just feel like it's some connection of some form is going to be advancing. It's going to be advancing. And what I'm feeling, even with Release Your Ex, maybe on an energetic level, there has to be some forgiveness here. Guys, I know this is like so like all over the place, but I feel like the situation may be all over the place. And this is why I'm getting it like this, is confusion. You have to make a decision. If you're going to, you know, be with a person or not, or are you going to open for love or not? I feel like that's a decision that has to be made. You know, maybe take this time, Scorpio, and work on yourself, okay? You have to be clear, though, because I'm not seeing this as you working on yourself. Are you going to put into a relationship or are you not? That's what I'm seeing. The decision is yours with this Six of Bows and the Four of Cups, boredom and abundance. You have to know, like, if you're in a relationship and it's one-sided, if you're in a relationship but you're just not putting forth the effort, you have a decision to make here. And depending on the decision that you make, Scorpio, is really going to dictate, you know, the outcome when it comes to love. That's what I'm seeing. Because even with these candles, I just feel like one flame is burning, you know, like it's really lit up versus the other flame. It's alive, but the flame is put out, and maybe you have to make a decision. And maybe it's hard because something is invested here. Take it as it is, Scorpio. It could be you or them. Okay? But that's what I see when it comes to love. And I just, honestly, I just want to go back to this card, playfulness. Because towards the end, it just got very heavy. It says, to recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. Go back to what feels good. Single or in a relationship, go to what feels good. So anything that Scorpio needs to know in the month of February, okay, that will bring you more fulfillment if you apply it to your life is blame. I accept responsibility for my well-being. So I really feel like releasing the blame, blaming others for what happened, you know, taking full responsibility, okay? Even if it wasn't you, Scorpio, making a decision to surrender it to the divine is going to bring you a lot of fulfillment, because we can't change people. We can't make them see. All right. And right here with protection and then with boundaries, I feel like some of my Scorpios are going to be making a decision to open up, because I feel like protection and boundaries are good. But too much of anything is not okay. And I feel like maybe you've just built this wall and you just closed off every single thing. You know, like when you build a wall, understand nothing can get out and nothing can come in. And I feel like there's something with your boundaries or the way that you like overprotect yourself that I feel like spirit is asking you to look at. Because maybe if, and I know this is hard to hear, guys. Oh my God, believe me, I had a dose of this recently. When you start to take responsibility for your actions and yourself, you realize that we really can't blame people, because no one can do anything to you that you don't allow. Even if it's an unhealthy relationship, a situation, you know, unless you're a kid and you're, you know what I'm saying, your parents' house and you're getting abused. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about like in relationship or in your adulthood with work and career. You know, there's no need to judge it or complain about it or blame anybody. You know, I feel like when you surrender that over, you're able to really step back into your personal power and take back, you know, take your personal power back and make the decisions that you need to make, okay? We also have growth here. Realizing that everything that is happening is for your growth. There are no L's, you know, there's no losses, only lessons that help grow you. And in all situations, seek wisdom, seek clarity, go within, ask your spirit guides is what I'm seeing, okay? Now, the word that spirit wants Scorpio to keep at the forefront of their mind in the month of February, okay? Before you give an answer, reflect back on this word, and you know, the highest for all involved will play out, okay? So let's see what that is, spirit. what is that? What does that look like? Growth. Realizing that everything is for your growth. Use every opportunity to help grow you for expansion. And when you do it like this, Scorpio, this just even like ultimately lifts my spirit up, you know, realizing that nothing is wasted. The time or whatever you invested, it's not wasted. It taught you something. You know what I'm saying? So really looking at everything like that and that positive energy is really going to bring you a lot of fulfillment in the month of February. Okay, so I love you so much, Scorpios. It was such an honor to read for the beautiful soul that is watching this video. As always, I love you guys, and I'm sending you oodles of love, and I will catch you on my channel. Take care.